And welcome back. We are just approaching the second round of pit stops here. And currently, Ixion Motorsports lead from Genuine Racing in the Pro class after many, many strange incidents so far today, mostly one wheel calibration for NX Racing and looked like possibly a pop-up for Conquest Racing. So two of our leaders taken out of the equation so far by that. They're currently 40, well, NX are now 31 seconds behind the leader and Conquest are 44 seconds behind the leader. In amateur class, last lap motorsports lead for the two green Angus Racing cars. And in, of course, in the Pro class to complete top three are Team Virus. So, guys, how do you see the race so far? And are you looking forward to the next 22 hours? And will you be up all night?
Yes. No, no.
No, wait, there's three questions. No,
you think yes about the race?
I believe yes.
And on the topic of everything else, I believe no.
But, well, to the point of it, I think it was very hectic at the start, incredibly hectic. I mean, it's like, it almost seemed like an ITCC race.
Is that timing out?
Also, a lot of
Gajda
very unlucky.
Timing out.
Have I jinxed someone again?
It's still hectic and everyone got rubbish luck as Conquest Am time out of the race. That's the 68 car.
Almost 30 second lag already.
There we go.
And there we go. Conquest stay gets even better for the M car. 23rd before the timeout. And now they're not going to be higher than 23rd. Probably lower though.
I think they'd already
it happened in the first sector. Kalowski's already there to take a new car. He is out of the pits, yes, there we go. 68 back on track.
Apparently we cut off just as Tomek Nozjek was making a move. I'm happy to inform that I think he did make it stick.
And I'm also very close to the back of the SPB car now. He should maybe get the move done on the straight if he gets
a good
but he dives! Whoa! How did that work? How did that work? That was millimeters of a gap between them when he slotted in front of that car.
Kamui Kobayashi, eat your heart out.
Wow. It's what you call being in a hurry. Wow.
He was obviously late for something.
It seems like it. Technically, he was early for something, and that's his second pit stop because, well, technically, he hasn't really made a pit stop, he's just mended his car in a pit stop. They're still running the same strategy. If I remember correctly, it was 28 laps for Conquest last way round? Or last time round, even?
Maybe.
They're not too far away for second stop. Dennis Lind isn't going to try and do 3,100 laps again. Scare all of us.
And Isaac Price for NX is up behind Krasmer of the...
Oh, Ray King's just span. Exiting the
right in front of this.
Yeah, things back in the way now.
Right on the bank, back bumper of Kresma now. Not getting better.
Kresma.
I doubt gonna be able to dive from there.
Oh,
just about getting its... Whoa, and that was a bit of a lag crash there. That wasn't both of them failing, that was a lag crash. Kresma's car stopped middle of the road there for a second.
As we've just crept past the 2-hour mark in this race.
Only 22 to go, a sprint now.
Well, that's obviously what some of these drivers are thinking.
Also, call Pronomon, which is car number 14, is in the pits. We set second pit stop phase now, on top of the hour. Now, Kresma being passed by Price, down the inside of the kink.
The Scuderia gas car, was it? There, chopping across where Price was going.
It was a bit of a...
back up fifth, but the gap to the leader, that's it today, is still quite large, although, well, seeing the rate at which the leaders have problems, it's probably not too large, actually.
Surprisingly, there have been no protests yet in the entirety of the race, when we thought there would be about 20,000 after lap 2.
Right, on fighting for 7th place there against Major of LLM Amateur. Well, just yet again, he would probably wish that he had DRS in our FZR, because he's just about too far back to get the draft. I mean, he is still... Oh, he goes off the track! Oh, whoa, whoa. Bit hasty there in the draft. And obviously, he is still on the same strategy. He did not change tyres in his second pop where he fixed the car, or nor did he refuel, I suppose. And he's now been let pass by Major. I thought that was going to end in a massive accident. Luckily, no contact was made. On to his way, he goes. There's the next car for him is the number 15 of Kresma, who's going to be taken over by Felix Zillen. Probably at the end of this lap when they're pitting.
As our leaders have pitted in, just on their way out now, driver change, Djakovic has given the car over to Taskinen. So unbelievably, even though he's not made a stop, that puts Isaac Price back into third position. not a million miles away from the guys running up towards the front either. So, been a very good stint from Isaac, despite his issues and drive through that he got handed to him from Winyabi. Nogiek also doing a good job at the moment. Looks like Taskinen has come out just behind Nogiek, and more immediately, Major, who is our GTM leader. Movai and Laprovot still trying to take chunks out of each other on track. I'm not sure where that's going to lead for either of them. Just going to flick over to my tyres now so that I can shift tab through to see who's going to pop them first. As Jonas Koskinen's got a bit of interesting damage on the front left of his car. I don't know how long that's been there for. Looks like Guljovic has had an issue for the LLM Pro car as well. He was going slowly through the first sector. TRR exiting the pits now. 18th position, Ostgaard handing over to Tanskanen. I guess the real story here would be if Dennis Lynn could get it to 2 hours 20.
He might be close-ish.
If he can get it to, like, that mark, so is it in the pit lane on 2 hours 20, then it's feasible that he could, well, the Infiniti Pro car could end up saving 4 pit stops throughout the race. As we've got Isaac Price in the pit lane for Inex, so that's going to put them back a few spots again. But like I say, it's still a very good stint from him, having come from such a poor position at the start of it to now be where he is. Very impressive. As when Yavi's going to take over again, hopefully he can keep it in first gear in pit lane this time. I myself am going to be taking a short break and joining, well, not myself, but entering the commentary box now. He's been here all along, but for the first time vocally, it's Thilo Falkenberg, and with a bit of luck, our very own resident, Stephen Martin.
Yeah, good evening, everyone out there. It's all Steve.
So, you go ahead.
So we currently have a very busy pit lane, it seems. Just the town killer is now out of the car for Vortex. Lutelot is taking that one over. Town killer with the, most likely unluckiest stint of all times.
Yeah, that's right, it was in the gravel twice, it's been two laps. It must have cost him several laps for getting out. But he's still going, and he's got 21 hours 47 minutes to make it up. So plenty of time.
So it is. Dennis Lynn's still out there.
Indeed, his first stint, I believe, was an hour and 12 minutes, much longer than anyone else made it, so he could still be out another 2, 3, or 4 laps, perhaps.
Yeah, especially if you look at the tyres, they're not looking too bad. Jacob Cooper into the pit lane, Hydiniak taking over that one. Very stretched out field currently. Closest affair on the track is for 14th position. Front push, we took the car over from, I believe, Kevin Loy earlier. He's in 13th now because he passed the
second car in the third lane. We got the Savage Simple's AM car in the gravel at turn 3.
Oh!
It's a number 60 car that's Parnanen from 12th place.
Parnanen. He seems to be getting out.
Very slowly. He's got to be careful getting back onto the track because he'll rejoin right on the racing line.
Very dangerous place for something like this. One tyre on the grass at least.
He's really struggling to get out.
And
seems to be going anywhere at the moment.
If you're monitoring this, he's spinning more likely round into the wrong direction. And now an additional rescue car is coming from the pit line to assist. Doesn't seem like he's getting out of it in first gear. And this will be a major loss for him. He's already 2 minutes 25 into this lap. And as it was said earlier, this is a place where you usually just some 20 seconds into the normal lap.
Indeed, he must have lost at least 2 minutes already, and he is really not managing to get out on his own, so Jonathan Palmer in a rescue car is coming to give him a hand.
Meanwhile, Dennis Lind does another lap. Going to push him back to spin him a bit so that he doesn't return to the racing line directly, which is actually a good thought. Now he's on the grass, now he's getting some grip again.
Now he's just waiting for a gap in the traffic, and he can get back on his way and trying to make up some of that time. He's 3 minutes and 50 seconds into this lap, almost 4 minutes, and he's only at turn 3. So he's lost at least a lap and a half from that.
Yeah, and he also seems to be having
a puncture on his left front. Which is really just rubbing salt in the wounds.
That might be the reason why he ended up in that place. Puncture right in the braking zone, and then you cannot keep the car in track, usually.
And the trouble with this is, of course, not only does he have to pit to get that tyre changed, but he is also having to struggle around the lap well off racing speed just to get back to the pits.
He hasn't pitted yet. Dennis Lind hasn't pitted yet, and now he's coming around the final turn and he stays out.
Very brave from Dennis Lind there, very thin tyres now, but as it was Dom Roscoe was saying earlier, if he can get 2 hours 20, could he actually stretch this this stint out and continue on as far as he can go? Plenty of sense.
Savage now crawling back.
Ooh,
spinning! Nearly spinning completely around, and it happened. Now into the pit lane entry. The biggest problem that can now happen is a car that's also going to pit. It's running right into the back of it, but it doesn't seem so. They are safe and secure. With a lap time of over 6 minutes.
And he's struggling to stop at a pit box. A couple of times he missed them, so that's cost him precious additional seconds.
I think we can easily say this altogether costed him at least 2 laps. they even changed the barber in this situation.
Right, well down the pit this time. He's around the final few corners now, I'm assuming you will do this time. Into the pit lane. Yes. No.
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 We're staying out for another lap.
Well, it's hero or zero time for Dennis.
Although this is just the second pit stop, you must remember. Oscar's calculations might be right about saving four pit stops if the team can keep this strategy alive throughout the 24 hours.
I think he's in high gears and he needs to be. I think he's saving fuel. It might have been a mistake to stay out that long. He's in fifth gear going through this right-hander that's far too high. He might be struggling to get this round back to the pit. He might have stretched it a bit too far, which is quite a silly mistake to make in only the hour of this 24-hour race.
What's also going to be interesting to see is if he's doing a third stint in a row.
I suspect he might be. Out the final corner he comes again, Dennis Lint. I assume this time he'll definitely be pitting. Yes. Careful. Oh, he's out of fuel! He's gonna hit the wall!
Oh.
He's hit the wall! Dennis! Dennis, what have you done, Dennis? Dennis is out of fuel!
He's
just gonna make it back to the... Yes, he's out of fuel. He's doing that funny stuttering thing. Hit the wall in the pit entry. And was running out of fuel. That could have been an absolute disaster if he'd run out of fuel while spinning around for Dennis Lint there. But he makes it to the pits. Probably
second place, Ixion is currently in the final hairpin. So they will easily take the lead back.
Lynn will be second, you'd imagine, probably. Very interesting, top four.
He loses second place as well, it seems. And third place is back and forth.
The genuine racing car goes up ahead of Dennis Lint.
There's coming Ventiali. So, this might be in reach. No, it isn't.
So, rather amazingly, Hector right back in it, and Conquest, I don't think, far behind either.
Quite remarkable how fast NX Racing came back to fifth position.
Indeed, if Dennis Lint keeps doing that, then it's going to be interesting to see if he manages to save a pit stop and how far he can get ahead, how the rest of his team cope with such a setup and how they can cope with such tyre wear.
Indeed, going a couple of laps longer on every stint will certainly help over the course of 24 hours, especially if it remains in flat conditions as it is now. But, of course, as you say, Chris, it might be down to the way Dennis is driving. We'll have to see how his teammates get on, whether they can replicate this sort of tyre wear and fuel usage.
Indeed, I mean, it's all Hungarians on the team roster after this, very, very experienced drivers, so it's all down to how they get on with this setup as well. I'm sure that they'll be ready to go and they'll be confident of matching Dennis's pace on this stint, so we'll just have to see. I think they're the former Infinity Skills guys, if I remember rightly. Feel possibly no more than I do.
I don't know more than you.
Well, that's useful. Where's Dobby?
Dom usually is the walking archive of Blitzkrieg.
Miro Rauti's actually catching up 0.6 of a second a lap for the race lead. And Maurice is going with him for the genuine racing, so Ixion could be coming under some pressure very, very soon for the race lead. Who would have thought the Big Evil might lead a race?
Stretched out at the moment. The closest group is actually the top 5 here. And visually it seems like Ventiali is now getting closer to Dennis Lind. Dennis, of course, with a full tank of fuel.
Indeed he is. Ventiali has taken 0.75 seconds out of him in the first 2 sectors alone on this lap.
Oh, and we've got a timeout. Koskinen.
Bad dream for Vortex continues. A 15.6 for Ixion. Gap 4.9 seconds. 15.78 for Virus, so Virus losing a little bit of time.
There's Giovanzu, who is actually taking over the 22. Now leaving the pits. How many liners was it for the Vortex? Was it already the third? And we can now welcome back the walking archive of Lipspeed, as I called him earlier, Dominic Engel is back.
Yes. Now I can ask my question again. Walking archive of great knowledge and power.
Yes.
The Infinity Hungarians, they're the former Infinity Skills Hungarians, aren't they?
I believe so. I think that team.
Sorry to interrupt.
Sure.
Matthew went down. He goes through on Dennis Lim.
Oh,
make
in
it
that
stick.
Corner.
Ooh, just about,
Steve.
Yes.
Good spot.
Look brave to overtake a hard racer like Dennis into there.
I wouldn't have done it.
Thank you.
In the chat we've got some user desperately searching for team. It's the second time I spotted his name asking for team. So if your team searches the driver, there is someone really looking like he's willing to race. And no, Chris Wilkinson won't be here. He's currently camping somewhere in Great Britain.
See, we've actually come through a half of the second hour, and the leader is still the same as the leader was when I left. Which is shocking.
Did you catch the bit of the end of Dennis Lind?
Ooh, Dennis Lind's got very hot left rear tire. It's in very, very hot. A lot hotter than the rest.
Yeah, well, did you catch it that he ran out of fuel on the pit road?
That's dangerous.
He made it, if I remember it correctly, till 25, so he's just 10 minutes into his third stint.
Did another one of his amazing long stints then.
Yeah.
Wow. It's interesting in many ways because I think he's going longer than anyone else is.
His second stint was 32 laps long.
Another one. Wow. It's basically means he's just on his fourth lap, or finishing it. It's pretty impressive. I think there's a battle being up for sixth between Hedlund and Noggy Edge. That are in the battle. So it should be quite fair.
Mercedes F1 team really are a joke, aren't they? They were supposed to be launching the car 2 hours ago or something like that.
No, not long. Their car only presented on the web. They're launching their car on Monday.
Oh, yes, yeah, still. Okay, so they're presenting the car.
I have a Sauber, Force India, and Ferrari, and Lotus have launched their car, although I doubt that was this year's Lotus.
The Ferrari's nose cone is very, very, very ugly.
Yeah, but then it's slightly less ugly than last
year. Oh, we got contact between Crompus and the dig breeding program and coming up the boot chicane.
Yeah, he was off track. Had to go all the way through the rubber curve of that chicane, I think.
Doesn't seem to have too big problems or damage from that, so he can just drive on, even with a bit of time lost. Although losing time seems to have been a theme so far in this race. A lot of people have lost out of it.
Yep, including Savage Simsports 2, who ended up in the rubber trap at the second breaking point.
Isn't that Virus?
Yeah, the same place where Virus was.
Oh dear.
And that was for about 2 minutes, 2 minutes 30. They also had a puncture and crawled back, so they lost at least 2 laps.
Oh yeah, probably. Doing more punctures here than last race, which I'm surprised by. Whoa, Dennis Lind almost chopping off the 72 car of 6A Fonto coming out of the pits there. Still got his baking hot left rear tyre. Seems to be causing, seems to be losing him time for sure. And a 17:54 on the last, which is not the best of times.
I mean, he's really in his third stint. Was it in Norway after 4 hour limit for a driver?
Just don't think that you mean what you can do in a row.
Yeah, in a row.
I don't think there is a limit.
I thought there was. I know that at the Nürburgring for the 24 hours there is a 2 hours 30 minutes limit.
Oh,
sliding.
God.
Sliding through
and
that
left rear is getting worse. It's not getting better, it's getting worse each lap. Maybe that's just because he's second sector, I'll have to judge. Well, I'd see now in the F10 menu that Dennis Lind's got some nasty right rear damper damage, and that will make his car very oversteer in the right hander, so that'll explain where that tyre heat's coming from. But how did he get so much damage in 2 hours? He must have.
Oh, presumably that damage came from when he slammed into the pit wall upon entering the pit lane.
Ooh, should have repaired that. He should have repaired that because he's basically losing 1.5 seconds per lap at the moment.
It was very lucky to get going at all, because if he'd spun probably and come to a halt, he was on fumes. So if he had to get going again, he might not have made it to a pit box at all.
We have a battle for sixth position. Termite Factory and Conquest Racing.
Well, I was gonna say not yet doing another stint, but facepalm, he's still in the car from when I left, so. Certainly pushing. Oh, and that's, Lind apparently gonna pit. Oh, Dennis Lind is timing out! Dennis Lind is timing out!
Disaster for Infinity if he does time out. I think he will any second now.
Yeah, Cotroch is already on servo. He probably is yelling on TeamSpeak that he's timing out. But he can see no other cars. Yeah, there we go. Dennis's gone.
Is it with this new Live for Speed? Is that just a certain amount of time before the timeout actually happens?
Yeah, the timeout time has been extended, which means technically, if you have to rejoin yourself and don't have a teammate to do that, you lose more time than before.
See, that could be something that League admins should look at. That if you're actually timing out, you should be allowed to. And you come on the server and say, if you see your teammate 15 seconds timeout, then you should be allowed to go. Because if it's going to extend to 26 seconds, then there's actually. It's quite unfair in a way, if you know you're timing out.
The problem is if the guy actually returns to racing. And Felix Hillen now looking definitely into his rear wing.
Rear wing. It's my curse. I'm ruining everyone's commentary just by being here. He's too far away for the draft. Actually think that Terra car's a little bit faster down the straights.
Also a little bit. Well, more vital exiting final turn, I think.
I think he's gonna go for a knife here.
Round the outside!
Oh, but he's not run himself. Is he gonna get the draft from here? No! He's not gonna get the draft from there. Derek will probably just creep away. Yeah, there we go. He's creeping away now. Nothing more frustrating not being able to pass a car because of your straight line speed. I think it's only a matter of time. He's probably going to try and get past him before the third round of pit stops, you would expect. We have a further battle a bit lower down in the top 10 for 8th place between Yasila for LLM Amateur and Stick Breeding Program Pro's Jagovitz, who's closed in 4/10 on the last lap at the moment. Just be edging ever more closely through the sweeps.
That reminds me, we again have the LLM Amateurs in front of the LLM Pro team.
But the XR is probably very suited to this track. Maybe that's got something to do with it. Not much faster, but he's just that bit more close at the moment. Although
and
that's all.
Oh! No, that wasn't perfect. And we've got penalties now upcoming.
Got a drive for a penalty for Iris Amateurs, if that's something they would have needed today.
And
I think that's actually for, ironically, I think that's the chat, and I think it's also the chat that they made after they had moused out of the first gravel pit.
Exactly, before when they lost one lap, before they lost the second lap, just by being stuck on the lap.
And Barbosa now gets drive through for the 09 for avoidable incident.
But it's Folk with the penalty. Barbosa's just in the car. It's Folk, I believe, dive bombing and spinning out the Last Lap Motorsports Pro car about an hour in.
We've got a fight on the track for 8th overall between the 57, that's the LLM AM car, that's the leader in the AM category, and the Stig Breeding Program Pro car, number 21.
The Stig Breeding Program is very close.
Whoa, they're very close in the braking zone there. You're still sliding a bit. I mean, Jagger, that seems to be not having too many difficulties keeping up with that car at the moment. Looks like I want a P-Path, please. You're holding me up. It's not going to happen in this sector, probably. Not from this distance. To be relatively even on lap time. Whoa, you're still running on the poles there. Nice.
That's for position.
Oh, the Jagger dives! Whoa, and can he keep that one?
Yeah.
Seemingly so, he's through into 8.
He's through.
Bam, leader goes down on the snow roll into 9th.
Meanwhile, Conquest is still behind Terramite Factory.
Milne's probably not going to be one who waved him through. I think him. Yeah, that Terra Magnificus somehow, probably from lower wings, has got a quite nice advantage on the throats of 2 to 3kph, actually.
Oh,
Dodge making a bit of a mistake there, almost going off onto the grass on the outside of that chicane.
Probably lost another a couple of leaders.
Probably another opportunity missed. To get the overtake done around to the last sector of the lap. Straight to Terra car really just runs away with it. So we have a battle lower down for 16 between the Infinity Esports amateur car and Luis Barbosa for call pro number 2. Who's just
come out
of the pit after his drive for a penalty.
That is Hadniak, is how you pronounce the Infinity Esports driver. I'll probably get corrected on that one as well, but I do think it's Hadniak.
I won't comment on it. I simply haven't got a clue.
If you have a clue, just post it in the chat.
Why is called Proto so far down? Oh yeah, of course, they had the puncture, didn't they? They had the...
Yep, they had the puncture,
and they had the drive-through. And the drive-through, and a massive period of time where it really stuck, so... a lot of people, obviously, playing in the sandbox, intentionally. And they should get the draft now, easy. But Axel's out of it, now he goes for it. Sideline for the first kink, and well, that's already happened before turn one.
Okay, we've got a Jagadist losing tons of time.
Oh, he must have been through the gravel in the chicane. He's got 4 dirty tyres, so...
No. I believe that he was coming up to lap Cipolla and they came together.
Well,
because Cipolla was backwards at the exit of the chicane very briefly.
Oh, that's, is that Savage Sim Sports 1?
Yes, it is.
Oh, yeah. Well, even more luck for them.
I believe that's what happened, so it's not the Jagger that's actually made a mistake. I think there's just a coming together between faster moving car and some traffic.
Expected to pull away on the 57.
Yeah, there shouldn't really be a battle stem from that.
So I did notice till a few minutes ago that the third place AM car and 11th overall is actually an FXR in the form of Hellenic Racing.
You've always got to keep an eye on them because they're not always quick, but they just don't seem to make the characteristic errors that so many others do. and you get to this sort of stage in race, and you know, with the 3 hour or 6 hour races, this would be a brilliant time to be third in class and to be doing well. But you know, Hellenic Racing Team always impress with how they drive their FXR and have done so far this season.
I think they won a class in Firm Bay. Oh, I could be wrong though.
Don't think so, but I'm not gonna say that you are right or wrong.
Remember they ran in 7th overall there at some point in that race, which was 3 hours long, so it could have been for 12 seconds in the race and then they pitted and gone completely wrong and they finished like 28 or something. I think they certainly did. Probably not too nice option to be driving around this track in a very long race in a car, you know, is probably not going to do too well. Just to accept that fact and just go on about the race is probably very hard already.
And no, they didn't win the race.
No stick breeding program. Am, who are now pro, I believe.
Which one of them was 54?
Oh no, wait, it was Scuderia Gas. Yeah, I'm reading this at Scuderia Gas one.
Oh yeah. They also started in the top 5 in that race.
Hellenic Racing Team, looking at it, they've not even had a podium yet. They
got
0 point score in round 1. And that must
be because they rolled before the start. They didn't even cross the line to start.
It must be a fifth and a sixth for them, I would say. Or a fourth and a fifth.
Wow. I could have sworn they would have done better than that.
I am sort of like poking around for the actual results somewhere, but I'm just not finding them.
Nojak could be just fighting the draft of Hillen. Might just be out of reach this time round and into the Bubishing.
Yeah, he's just out of reach really, although that Infinity Am car in front of him, that could spice things up. Oh, Nojak very late on the brakes, using the wall to slow down his car. Okay.
Another game needs the wall to keep your...
Come to the 24 Hours Project Gotham Racing.
Yeah.
Another average day in a sim.
Whoa, there we go. If Nodja gets the exit... No, they both get the exit wrong, but Nodja gets it wrong the road.
Well, it looked like Hadniak sort of did get out of the way, but not in the best place possible.
But let's be honest, last corner had zero grip at the best of times.
So the team formerly known as Evo up in front, still.
I don't think that title would go down very well if we say it more often, the team formerly known as Evo.
Yeah, but it's easier to remember than whatever it is they are called, Terra Mind Factory.
That's just a sponsor for the Mind Factory.
I think they should have watched Talladega Nights before they figured out their sponsors and just picked something. Oh, the 74 is timing out.
Oh, who's timing out?
74.
That is. Isn't that not Merida Racing Team again?
I think so, yeah.
In the FXR. Well, and we're not sure yet if they're timing out, but the problem is. The longer you disappear, or the longer you don't send any packets, the less likely it is you'll stay on the server.
He'll be a goner at about 31, 32.
Yeah, there we go. 74 timed out. Christoph, who timed out earlier, has now joined to take over after a timeout.
Strategized as well.
The Christoph connect there for the 74 Merida FXR.
they're out going. Oh no, wait, that was the Hellenic FXR. It's... at least almost 1/8 into the race, no retirements.
Yeah, it's not bad. I suspect it being 24 hours, people are more willing to have another go when it, after it's gone wrong.
I mean, we gotta really look at teams like Virus. They've lost 2 laps in, like, I think after, I don't know, in the second hour.
Yeah, and, I think it was mostly second hour.
Remember the rule change from last race? There are no wafer rounds.
They physically do need to race back onto various laps.
They do need to race back onto various laps.
Which is hard to fathom considering how close the field is in reality. You've got to think that really they're just driving around hoping for other people to have problems.
But basically that you're doing, you know, it's like being Minardi in F1. I'm saying Minardi because Minardi were likeable, not like HRT who had brakes and steering racks failing.
Well, because they didn't get new parts half the season.
Could have made some out of wood.
I believe they took parts from the 2010 and the 2011 cars already.
You mean the Lara chassis, and they just sold bits off them and then nailed them to the car?
Yeah, something like that.
Dear.
From what I've read,
quite an early stop for the number 68.
On the hour, so it's okay. They already had a timer as well, didn't they?
I think, I think they might be a tad out of sync, and this might be them getting back into sync.
They are on number 27, so no problem there.
And meanwhile, Benyavi in the inner car has closed right up to the back of the genuine racing car in third place. They've got battles for third and fifth.
The leaders of the pits before the 3-hour mark. Could be slightly irritating for them for the rest of the race. So, Team Virus do lead the race now, guys and girls.
But Nano's just got a run on Hidden for what is now 4th place. It's at the outside for turn 1.
Whoa,
slight
contact,
but he makes the move stick.
So what that contact was all about there, Steve?
Only 23 laps for Ixion on this thing.
It's very interesting. Maybe they made an error with the amount of fuel they put in. Because usually you'd easily go, oh my god, that's not very good in front of that battle of the second. We have a lagging Christoph in a Merida FXR.
I get the feeling that Vignorvi was not very happy with him earlier as well.
But probably not been very happy with the other reasons as well earlier.
Sorry, not Vignorvi, Rauti. Because Rauti was fairly honking his horn in the exact same place as those two just came up behind him just now.
So Marines and Vignorvi went back in a second. Starting to find second at again, my question, how much do you know about the strategy of the car you're not on? Your team's done.
I am on that car.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm meant to be driving later on. So I'm here now, and I'll be here later.
Oh, you'll be here later. I think you're no longer disconnected at midnight anymore.
Hmm? Oh no, I don't still... get that anymore.
Good, well,
don't get
that's
that
rude.
Since 2 years anymore.
I told you it's been 2 years, Stefan. It's been 2 years.
At least it was easy to plan in. To be honest.
What, just a case of not the hour before, not the hour after?
No. But it always timed out at precisely 1:42 local time. Because my routes are reset.
Precisely?
Yeah, precisely. To the second.
That's fantastic in every way.
No, but since I switched provider and router, now that doesn't happen. I've got so much more internet speed and reliability, and much cheaper price. Actually, I could have just stayed there. To make a difference.
I think the only time I've ever come close to timing out of a race was this here Kyoto Grand Prix for the 12-hour race of LOE, where everything was going fine. We'd battle back from like last place at the start of the race because we was in turn one, and we're running. Third, I think, at the time, and we needed to make up time to, I think it was Infinity Skills. And everything was going fine, we were driving around, nice and calm, like consistently, doing decent left that time. So then all of a sudden, Chris, you're lagging. Why are you lagging out, Chris? Get in the pits now. And it turned out my sister was downloading movies on the internet and completely killing the internet speed. No,
oh,
I don't think she was
Felix, like, oh, tell me while struggling to
laugh. Oh, I was going to say that was... I didn't say anything, I just your army's on the back of my leash now, down toward turn number 3.
I think he's just going to very late.
Yeah, you're right, Dom, he is going to get the draft very, very late. Maryse doesn't really defend the inside line, Vignarvi down the inside, Maryse breaks nice and late though, nice and consistently late. Can he get the cut back? No, he just drifted on the middle of the corner, and Vignarvi's
got more to do
place.
With the turbo lag there, it's very hard to get the car going in third gear.
Drifting about a bit.
I see people overtaking to turn up. Oh no, he's going to run wide instead. I was thinking, is Maryse going to be brave enough? He's quite sensible racer, isn't
he? I don't think he wants to get involved in a battle on his in-lap.
Ah, his in-lap, okay.
Crazy's going, did you have
his? Oh, has he? Okay, well, I was not paying attention. His tires are nice. Nice. I think he's done a good job.
They're nice.
Nice. They're not Dennis Lind nice, where you think, oh my god, why is he driving on those?
He normally races the AM car, doesn't he, Dom? Maryse.
Oh, we don't have an AM car.
Yes, that's what I was going to say, Dom. He's your team leader.
I think he
needs
the other car.
He's doing a very good job, I think.
He's done the first two races in the SLR, yes.
I do definitely miss watching Robin Heidermann and his beautiful driving style.
Really? Oh, you'll be like.
Is he here today?
He's meant to be driving it, though.
Oh my goodness, that must be the first time since early 2009.
Oh, he drove the
no
last
way.
Bit as well.
Did he? Oh, that's... my goodness me! I don't know very much anymore since I don't really come on this game anymore. I'm looking around the teams and liveries and I just don't see anything I recognise anymore. The only reason I'm here today is because I was ill all yesterday and in my bed and I had to call off what I was going to do today. And then I found out Wilco wasn't here, so I thought, oh, I'll just come and join them and just sort of chat nonsense for 2 hours. I'm sure everybody's missed me.
Did you just say you don't recognise any liveries?
No, not a lot of them, no.
They've
quite
all
a few of them
changed,
completely different.
Dummy.
And
well,
there's a lot of different
ours,
name
ours
changes.
Ours has been the same for the last 20
Dom!
Years.
When have Jedi... when have Jedi ever had gold and black?
Always.
I don't know. Do you know what, Dommy? The only genuine racing skins I remember are the ones that made me have a crisis.
The one that were based on the Castrol livery.
Yeah.
Well, this one's also based on a Castrol livery.
Yeah, but not a good one.
Well, it's a Gary Rogers Motorsport V8 supercar.
Don't care.
In different
it's not
colours.
Green and red. Why is it not green and red, Dommy?
Because we're neither bullfighters nor eco-maniacs.
Maybe you could be a mixture of the two and then be Bambi.
and they get killed by my mad people with guns.
Yeah, since when haven't you been around? Just
the only reason to run this skin with the 20,000 different color scheme is because we don't have a new one. Could use the old one. People would probably not even recognize it anymore because we haven't used it for like 2 years.
I would.
But then you would probably go on and you have a crisis on stream.
Yes. Is that a bad thing?
I don't know, depends what time of day it is.
Maybe you could have known this can't be third place concentration point. By the way, if we keep on talking about Little East. I mean, that's very much the way it was.
I wonder actually, how many places where's the Ixion car gone?
It went to pit lane and returned to track and
field. Yeah, there it is. I wonder whether that is going to retain its lead after all the pit stops have been done. It's a bit too early.
Good question. From the looks of things, I would say no.
I'd probably say no either, because doing like 7-8 laps to 1.5-2 seconds faster is going to make a difference. Actually, it's talking about skins again, it's a shame we couldn't race our second car here, because I have the skin, the best skin ever in the eternity of the world.
I like that skin.
Now no one knows what we're talking about. Not been on stream.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Down into turn number 3, we've actually got a battle. It looks as though we're doing anyway. Maybe it's not, I think it's actually a car lap down. Never mind, ignore me.
Meant Hardinak and Makalowski, I guess.
Yes.
They're on the separate lines.
Yep, I got that eventually.
Leaders are the line for Telemine Factory.
That was going to go from.
So let's start talking how we'll get the safety car here today. We've seen cars stuck in the gravel trap so far. We've been able to rescue them adequately.
To be upside now.
Yeah, I think it's going to be late at night when there's going to be less people around from the admin team in order to rescue the cars from the gravel traps. Or it's going to be when there's a flip. And where's the car
going to
flip?
I'm going to tell you exactly
turn
what
9.
It is. I'm going to tell you
one.
Exactly what it is whenever I'm driving, because I always get the safety card.
But we are planning a competition of caution at 23 hours, 59 minutes.
Deck, I was just shouting in our ears.
You hope that was on stream.
Was that on stream? Wonderful. Oh,
sure,
no.
Shouts on stream, Deck.
No!
That's
a firm
competition caution for debris.
Right, so somebody might throw a hot dog onto the track or something.
You gotta. Those hot dogs are lethal.
You know something, right?
Would that count as every caution?
Well, I remember that fast race is probably old Bridgestone cars were able to race when they threw beer cans on the racetrack.
They didn't throw a safety car at.
No, they didn't.
Instead,
it would have been the most boring safety car period in history.
Instead they showed slow motion cameras with the cars running over the beer cans and them exploding.
You know what would be funny?
Especially since the Americans had these super slow motions. That was
If there had been a safety car for that, and Tiago Montiero had tried to pass the two Ferraris, and Ruben Barrichello would have taken out, it would have been funny.
The funniest thing ever.
Only Barra Hopeless goes out, because Barra Hopeless is the only one who will be taken out in a situation like that, because that's just what happens to Barrichello. Anyway, I was going to say, Miro Rowdy's tyres are smashing at the moment. I think he can go on for a fair distance.
And we've got a drive-through for the number 22 Vortex. Stop go. I'm reading and listening and doing something different. But stop go for car 22, which was for an avoidable contact a short while ago, really improving their day that way, which has already gone ever so well.
Yeah, but we're 58 and that lost them a lap, remember? So it is
that really small.
We've got
there,
a couple of
small side point there, definitely.
Turn 1 and 2. That's the AM category lead. The lead pair have obviously come together. That's the stick breeder program car.
Your Silla's destroyed.
Oh, that car is completely bent.
Oh, yeah.
Gonna be bad somehow going straight.
Benjami
going fast.
I've not seen that much damage.
You mean wishbone?
Well, yeah.
The dampers are ones that are vertical, not horizontal.
If you
have horizontal
dampers, I was just being mentally handicapped.
Well, if there's nothing more than so far, a good job of looking very scary as well.
White flags out. At least he survived that corner.
Finally found that car. How on earth has he done that? Where has he done that?
Must have been.
Was that the last
one? Yeah, that was the car that led on.
Oh, crazy.
It was a lead fight. I only caught the aftermath of it, but it was a lead pair in turn 2, in that first complex.
Ricky, it's time for me to go on my replay then, Stevie boy.
Wow, that's a full repair there. They've just come out of the pits from the looks of it, because their tyres are brand new. Probably don't even have to change them, which is at least one good thing.
I think they had a decent lead, so you might be right there, Dom. They must be coming out of the pits and then sort of be into battle, potentially.
Either they did something very weird, or there was a massive land crash. Well, them or whoever they were fighting against, SPB, I guess.
They had a lag. They had a large lag return and slammed into the wall.
Whoa. So, again, it's the same theme. Don't be a leader if you want to do well.
Speaking of leaders, Rowdy pits from the lead. So Vanjavi puts Enix back into the lead for the first time since their first pit stop.
Oh yeah,
at the hour mark.
But that they'll probably lose it again after the pit stop.
Yeah, I mean, just he comes back on and he just appears again, and then suddenly the SBP car and him are crashing.
Yeah.
Well, if it's a lag crash between those two, you probably can't protest the internet.
No, there's nothing you can do there.
The weirdest protest I've ever seen was in City League, where someone tried to protest the lights.
Protesting the lights because they're wrong.
Thank you.
just noticed both DP cars are now in line with each other, 8 and 9. That's not happened too often either. Vangiari's coming in pits on lap 86 of a lot of laps in this 24 hours. Time being extra careful on the pit entry.
He made it. But so
we're gonna see where puts them, whether who will go by, whether Virus will go by, whether a couple of other teams will go by. Mary Lotto already in. Ah! Could that be. I think it could be very tight. It should be Virus position. Yeah, there we go, they passed.
And there comes Ixion.
Xion, yeah, there we go. Tuskinen passed. He's already further into this. Did he not only do 20 from that before he passed the stop?
He pitted 20 minutes ago. He pitted at the top of the hour. Well, just before that.
Very scared since the end of the second, middle of the third hour.
It's a bit of a shame that it is the spread out, because I guess now it's going to be such a case of you wait around until someone has a timeout and it puts them next to another person.
Better like this than to have Blackwood number two, which I think no one here wants.
Well. Yeah, it's nice that it's a big
only
track.
Only thing that got spread was
I think this is a battle of position between Core and Infinity Esports down in turn number three.
Yeah, that's... Wait.
Never mind that, there is a battle of position between Juicela and Krompus.
Infinity Esports is still on the lead lap. That's what Tracker says.
It timed very early on in the lap, so that's kind of at least not compromised them in that way. Cotteroch isn't the slowest of those drivers.
No, but Juicela and Krompus is for position. That's 13th on track at the moment.
Yes, it is, yes. Oh, Juicela. Please don't die from here.
Dive bombed! No, he's not.
Oh, he's done the sensible thing and braked early and stayed behind and it's gonna overtake him now.
Oh,
and it's gonna lose traction, almost run into his back and lift off.
Well, that said, if he can properly string together these last few corners, he can get him on the front
just
stretch.
The problem is the XR hates these corners.
Problem is, well, Krompus isn't going quickly. No, I think he's safe though, isn't he?
By Schneebus. I would expect you still not be very happy.
Oh, and Rodriguez and Folk have collided.
Dear.
Oh, he made contact with Cartridge.
He's just bussing about.
He's busting with his bus. What's going on there? You pushed him right the way out as well.
Not sure they're very immune to that, neither Infinity nor Core.
Well, Rodriguez is trying to fight back.
Please tell me. No, he's braked early. Okay, good.
Maybe he's not really aware of.
Oh dear. Oh, Cotteroch made a bit of a mistake! And there we go! Big crash!
Well, you've got to think. I know it's obviously not fair, but you've got to think that was coming.
That was always happening.
Well, when you're pooling about in front of people that are that much quicker.
Oh, Colin for the. That was very close.
Niner. I'm not even quite sure whose fault that was, because...
I think it's unfair to say it was anyone's fault. It was
I think it was
their fault for pootling around at 12 miles per hour for quite as long as they did in front of people that were actually going quickly.
You wash out wide into a car, and that's basically what happened to Core. They washed out wide into that FXR and completely spun it around.
Very true.
The thing is, I think the contact was no one's fault, but the aftermath of it.
A contact was always going to happen. All cars sharing 4 centimeters of track.
Yeah. So for the contact itself, I wouldn't give a penalty.
I'm surprised they even got through the last complex, really, the way they were driving.
I'm surprised the 72 FXR basically lost no more than 9 seconds. A very elegant free steam. Got a bit of left rear damage, but not much. This has been far, and that's only 1/8 of it.
Don't say that.
It's not been boring.
No, it's not been boring. It's been
stretched out.
It's been incredibly fun.
Just 20 hours to go, boys. 20 hours, 36 minutes.
Yay! The yellow flag approaching the chicane. Someone drop his car there.
No, there's nothing there. Just a guy running across gravel.
Careening over the gravel.
Yusilla and Krompost is still very much on. They're right behind each other. Well, not behind each other, but Yusilla is right behind Krompost.
Right behind each other. Inception.
Playing Portal 2. Here we go. At top speed.
Well, Krompus is 2 seconds slower than Kevin Loyables on this car. Which instantly reminds me of my 16-hour race in this combo.
16-hour? Oh yeah, that was 4 years ago.
Yeah.
The 16-hour race that you had 4 grids, 4 servers.
Yes, it had.
It was insane.
It was also insane that the one who should take over my car didn't came to the server.
Ever.
So I had to do, instead of a double stint, a quadruple stint. That wasn't my experience with endurance racing.
I've had a few in LFS, none particularly pleasant memories, but...
You're not going to have the FE4R season now, is
it? Even though I ended up on my lead twice, I genuinely enjoyed that.
Yeah, well, you probably enjoyed the bit where Wilco mobbed me on the track.
But what got me is that I rolled twice in one stint and still didn't do as bad a job as Wilco.
He tried to take out twice. I think I was second when I was driving.
Yeah,
he tried
because,
to wipe me out twice.
Because we're all within the same team at the time. So we're driving different class cars with the teams. And I think Wilco just sort of tried to get out of your way and inherently got right in it, didn't he?
Yeah, Wilco, I think what he did was... One thing, he slid over the grass and just came out in the right in front of me in a rear end.
The other time, he made me go into a really fast corner, very shallow, and I completely clattered the wall. I'm sure CSF can tell you all something about that race. He's here, but,
Hello, what?
Well, we just happen to be talking about the FE4R69 race. The Wilco's exploits. You made me crash twice.
He's in the UFR with me and Isaac Price, I believe.
Yes, and I was in the GTR with Seb, Simon, and myself. Oh no,
had to drive
yeah, Dom, yeah, you were in that as well, weren't you, Dom?
Yeah, I was in it.
That was another thing, that race was GT1, GT3, and...
GT2. And we were in GT2, we should have won the race. We should have won the race, but we were struggling because we had this ridiculous setup. And that only Seb could make work by driving really aggressively. And... he told us not to hit the wall, and we hit the wall. And he got all angry, and then he said he was driving the rest of the race to try and win it. And then he completely ruined the car and handed it over to me, driving a three-wheel car. And I was knackered, it was terrible.
He's got us 20 seconds to his penalty for cutting.
Then I crashed into Isaac twice because I wasn't paying attention.
As you can tell, that race was successful for us.
Oh, we suffered a second!
We finished third!
Yeah, the 16-hour race never really got... didn't really get better after the first one, did it? Two were great, and then the last...
The first one was in 07.
Was the first one in 07? Well, the first one I remember was, what, wait? Yeah. Was it not Kyoto?
Yeah, it was Kyoto.
That's the race I was talking about.
I think that was the race that I... Was it that or MOE? No, I woke up drunk at my keyboard. I'd fallen asleep on my keyboard. And then I threw up on myself. That was here as well. That was 2 years ago now. But no, but I'd been out the night before, I just turned 18, and I was on Ventrilo after I'd come in drunk. And then I sort of woke up just as the race was starting, and Jason Love was on the parade lap. And I was like, what's going on here?
You know, it must have been a while ago if we were on the NDR and Ventrilo set.
No, it wasn't NDR, it's Storm Racing's Ventrilo.
Even longer.
Asian history.
But it was so long ago that my former team manager, Jason Matthews, wasn't even interested in league racing at that point. Here. Fun times.
You guys must have been around longer than me now.
This is my 5th anniversary in March.
Today,
in April.
Not today, this year in July, it's 4 years.
Shit, I've... 4 years, excuse my friend, I've been around longer than both of you then.
Oh, yeah, you what was the name of your
team?
Renault Simsport.
Not on stream.
Renault
Simsport,
Oscar Hardwick. If anybody would like to link to that, tweet me. I'll provide it for you.
Chris, genius. Chris, it was Renault Autosport Demo, that's what it was.
Yes, oh dear.
You may mock Renault Autosport Demo, but one day it shall return.
They will return and they will dominate the world with Oscar's team manager.
Hey, Inex, watch out. Just saying. Watch out.
Red closed.
I think it might have. But it was great fun when it wasn't.
Yeah, it was great fun when it wasn't, I think.
Yes, it was closed because I got it back up and running when I found it.
Yeah.
And everybody was congratulating Oscar, and some people took it seriously.
I gotta say, one thing about that, Red, not even talking about what it was about, but. Oscar, did you type with your toes or something back then?
Yeah, I was actually a quadruple amputee when I was 12. But luckily my arms grew back and my legs.
I think Dom's English has always been better than your English back then.
I think it's probably still better now. I've just chosen to attempt to spell on more occasions.
I'm a posh bastard.
You're Scottish, so we're even.
I'm posh for Scottish.
Why? Because we can understand roughly every other word that you say.
No.
Not all of us are Tories.
That was actually the discovery of my life when I entered this Olympus community, that even native speakers spell things wrong. And I was so... so
disgusted at our insolence towards even our own language.
Well, Oscar's spelling and grammar probably led to the creation of Dolan Comics.
Yeah, Dolan Comics before they were cool. Just go read the thread.
Oscar's.
No, interestingly, but a few years after that thread was created, I got 2 A's in GCSE English.
And that is what's wrong with the English education system, everybody on stream.
Interestingly, I got them through the Welsh Board of Education, but that's besides the point.
All you had to do was go with a sheep and you get it.
I did write a story about sheep, it was a love story.
Oh, there's a surprise.
Oh my god, that is laying Wales.
Call Racing just overtook ASX for position and is now in 17.
Swiftly moving on, thanks, Steelo.
Yeah, Steelo just cutting in there.
I have a feeling if at the end of the day anyone is saying, oh, the race was boring from ASEAN country group, then one must say, when we talk about other things, we just missed all the action.
That is primarily what we're here to do as commentators.
Currently, there is a fight for first place between Pira Rauti and
Tuskinen. They're a bit close.
Apparently they were already side by side on the oval, and we missed it because we were talking about bad spelling and Dolan.
Well then stop being mean to me and pay attention.
It's fun.
There's currently only 2.4 seconds covering the top 3. And 6 the top 4.
For a certain person in this chat, Wilkin is not here today to commentate.
Wilkin is not here today, that's very much correct.
I know, he's training for being African or something.
I did not say that, but ooh, Rowdy honking his way through there.
Now, I think that Rowdy's not been Norvirus Pro, the quickest of these top 5-6 cars so far in this race.
Actually, I think Miro's doing a splendid job. He's actually very, very consistent.
He's doing very well, but away from that, he's still not been one of the, you know, top 2 or 3 in terms of outright pace.
But then again, Taskinen is already way longer into the stint. He's probably 15 minutes or so ahead in the stint. That's probably why he's
driver swap for Vortex. As Sebastian Hutchinson gets back in the car.
How further will he get this stint?
How many laps did he make last?
6.
5 is how many I think he'll get this time.
Dion Pirelli's.
Black ground, Pirelli. Hello, Simon Cattell.
Be so much better to have an airworn F1 because then the tyres would be horrible and degrading very quickly, even without them being designed to do so. Oh, Conquest almost spins in the chicane. Saw that there in the background.
Ooh, Taskinen!
Oh,
this isn't MotoGP, son.
Yeah.
It's worse, it's the British Touring Communism Championship.
Do you get leaf, Dorothy, here?
Side by side.
There we go, that's 07. Ixion going through now. Who's got the better top speed? And it seems like Ixion prevails. Oh! Boom. I think that was a bit of lag there. Don't think that was necessary either of their fault.
I think Routy turned in slightly early, but the lag extenuated the contract.
Contract again. He's got a 4-year contract.
Would you like a contract?
I would like a contract.
Now, could you please sign this contact for me?
I'd like a contract where people supply me with lots of money for no reason at all, or many years.
You mean like footballers?
Oh,
And we've got Inex.
You should be happy that you can't hear some of the things that are being said here on Whisper Binds.
And I completely missed what Dom was saying because I was talking at the same moment.
I was saying the truth. Wonder whether Mary Luoto is also gonna get involved in this.
Thanks. That was what I was talking about.
Try to make up for it. for my very rude interruption. Oh, no, wait, that's Ulrich, that's me. I thought that was Rowdy for a second, Jesus.
That's not Rowdy.
Favourite spot on the rack, Ulrich.
Oh, it is re-ended!
Just a bit, but a bit is still... Well, it still happened.
Poor Torsten Ulrich seems to get punted around a bit by the front runners.
And even though NX was having some contact issues with that TRR car, they were over a second faster, 1.5 seconds faster.
I think the Rowdy and Taskinen, Taskinen and Rowdy obviously touched enough each other in turn one, and I guess that's contributed a lot to their slow lap time. Mikko has been bashed around a bit by other cars, so. Right, it has to be said, the general traffic situation has been okay here today. We've had a few moments, but then I think we would have had more moments if we had two proper classes with two different car specifications.
Well, the thing is, originally there was a call to have two classes, and then it got to a point probably midway through last year, probably a bit earlier, people were saying, can we go back to one class racing?
Produces better racing in general.
It does.
It's basically like long time endurance series, which has about 4,000 GT3 cars running in 80 million different classes, which are, I think, Pro and Gentleman Trophy and the Citation Cup, which are obviously 4 million.
Pro is good. Pro Am is.
Brand
but
is
you
good.
Need some bad as well. Gentlemen
yeah,
is old people with lots of money, and the other one I don't know.
And Citation Cup is.
Cody makes a mistake, and now we've got Ivex in second position.
Oh dear. That's how quick it can go. Now the next auto row is number 10, Jenner. Well, is there gonna be something as well? I mean, Rowdy's not been slow, but just one mistake if you're running bumper to bumper, and that's it. You lost the place.
What's really impressive is that Ulrich still is keeping his pace.
Yeah, I've noticed, because they keep battling amongst each other and losing time.
And now Ivanov is using all his flashlights to show Ulrich to give them room, and that's a very interesting way to give room, actually.
Oh, there's been contact. I heard that. There's been contact between him and the virus car. You could probably go as by saying that's a dangerous track joining, although, well, you should have seen it coming in a way.
So now 3.5 seconds cover the top four in the race.
After 3 hours and 40 minutes.
Not bad.
We come to logic mode, where things make sense.
Got a lead battle.
Battlingham class, yes. Hellenic Racing Team and Green Angus Racing 62.
Go, bus, go!
I wonder whether Purse will bust his way out of the last corner. Cut it!
That
wasn't a very bus-astic exit.
He should have been doing a Nicky Dakovich line through there.
He could have kept the draft of this. Oh, a bit of weaving here.
Routy, meanwhile, with another mistake. Now, Ivanov is really close to him.
I jinxed that again.
Oh! Late braking by Ivanov, but can keep the car on the right line. Just not close enough.
Hellenic Racing Team right up behind now! He's gonna make a move to the outside.
They're gonna surround the outside. Except if they're not in any room, but it looks like they are. Hello, we have four-wheel drawing.
You know, the FXR is such a sad sight to see, it may as well be a diesel as well.
A diesel, or that runs on that biodiesel, that Audi, are you?
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know, made from,
For those guys asking for a tracker, go to tracker.newdimensionracing.com.
Or alternatively, newdimensionracing.com/tracker.
Or even more alternative, go to foxracing.com/stream. There you've got everything.
Kras is now very close on a back bump and he should have the draft, but he's not gonna be able to dive, or is he? No, he's gone out of it, but Miro made a mistake. Miro ran out of braking zone. Oh!
Well held!
Jesus!
Whoa!
Crash into each other, please.
Certainly a lot more sensible than last year is Crassy, no doubt about that, and that was a fantastic save at the exit of that corner there. Routy just running into his quarter panel. Not really, I don't think it was intentional the
not
slightest.
Sure, but I'm not sure which of them was more shocked by what almost happened. Yeah, that's good after the first place. I bet I was more shocked than anyone.
Yes, he's starting to begin to pressure on this race. He was a bit quiet at the start of this race, but now, having given over the car to Maurice in the second stint, he's now firmly in the battle for the lead here. Nozick is only 12 seconds behind this group.
I think the important thing about this race is the depth of your roster.
But earlier I was going to say the important thing about this race is that you always need to plan ahead and to be careful and cautious, but apparently no one else thinks like that.
I think cautious is the word which is not really in that dictionary.
No. After this lap, let enter the 100th lap for this race. Just apparently, if this race runs fully green, we're going to have roughly 647 laps at the end of the 24 hours. For
got his own map, quite a number. I mean, they're not going to get safety cars from Ford, like people at Daytona, for example, the Burger King 24.
Yeah, but there's been the unique situation of a safety car at the Nürburgring also
for the... Was a safety car in race?
Yeah, it was a safety car, a real safety car, period.
How did they get one? Because surely they never had one.
Well, they actually used the cars they called safety cars around the Nürburgring and let them around the track. I think after half an hour after the safety car, the race was red flag.
You mean after 2 laps?
Yeah, after 2. Slightly more,
slightly something,
yeah, 2 laps.
If you go in safety car, you're probably going to lose more than just a second or two.
Yeah.
You're probably going to lose a couple of minutes around that track. I hate it when I switch through cars and people are making slides. I always think they're going to explode or something. Scary.
In Live for Speed, we do not have exploding cars. You're forgetting Live for Speed is a 10-year-old game, Tom. We don't have these.
It's not 10 years old. Not 10 years old. It's 8 years old.
Oh, yeah, forgive
S2
me.
Is. Remember, there are some documentations about very funny bugs in MOE races in the very old threads where people are stuck in the road because there's suddenly a bug pit stop and they're stuck in the middle of the track. No longer happens.
We're coming up to 6 years this year, I do believe, since the last physics update. Do you know that?
And the last physics update was on the 21st of December, 07.
Oh, well, in 6 years. Okay, so we just got past 5 years, so yeah.
Now we're in the sphere. Well, you could technically say Patch Z was a physics update because the balancing was changed.
What was that physics update also with? The introduction of
the FBM and updated Blackwood and yeah.
I'll tell you something right now, guys. Merlito has caught Taskinen, and Ivanov has caught Merlito. We are ready for a battle royal, boys and girls.
And an hour ago, there was another car in front of them, which ran Thunder.
Bloody hell, Ivanov 14-1, the other two 15-2, 15-4. Ivanov is suddenly at ease with this car and it's absolutely on an absolute charge.
Nero Rauti also with a 14-9. And Tom, the Conquest car with a 14-6.
Has not yet been in that car since the start?
No, he gave... No, maybe he has.
Yes, he has. So that's four stints in a row.
Yes.
Hey, man.
Well, Tommy,
that actually was the plan of the stint as well. Until he was stopped by that tunnel.
I think Mary Lotz is only gonna watch his mirrors more than he can watch look ahead at the moment. But actually, the splits are exactly reversed.
Oh my goodness, this is it.
Oh, don't do anything funny.
Just
do something funny, but don't crash.
Mary Lotz took his wide. Hasn't quite got the run on him though.
I think they're all in the draft. I think he's just got it. He's got it now. No. Yes, no.
I think he's gonna get it way too late.
A bit.
Would have got it like at the end of the straight, but that's just the it's the end of the straight where you don't want it. You want it at the beginning of the straight, or halfway through it. Ideally, always off.
He's gone. He's gone.
He's done too much. Oh.
He's professional into the wall. There are two cars. There's a car coming.
Yeah.
It's Tomek. Okay, he's through.
In all fairness, that was a pretty good recovery. And he pointed the nose at the wall so the suspension wasn't damaged, and then got it going straight away, kept the momentum.
Did I miss something? I was gone for 2 seconds, and
yeah, Ivanov went off.
And just ran wide out of one onto the grass, and just ran a bit too wide onto the grass. And that's
the thing is, we are now going to quick break, just to don't miss a fight for the lead.
See you in a minute.